Okay, I present Konstantinos Asikis. It's a PhD candidate in urban planning in the Faculty of Architecture of the University of Athens, and he works in Farkadona Municipality as urban planner also. He's presenting this communication also along with Afroditi Camara, historian and PhD, director, founder of Time Heritage, with the title of Resilience and Sustainability in Little Towns, the Virtual Circle and the Collateral Benefits, the case of Farkadona. This is maybe going to give Celia some ideas also on how to break these negative vicious circles, because we are talking now, we're going to hear about positive virtuous circles. So all yours, Konstantino. Thank you very much.
So the topic is the resilience and sustainability in the little towns, the virtuous circle and the collateral benefits in the case of Farkadona. So the rural space. Little towns in Greek countryside present some inherent differences in comparison to little towns in other European countries, particularly in the north, because they don't usually guarantee the same level of economic, cultural and educational autonomy as the latter. Youth are very likely to abandon the countryside and the rural entrepreneurship in exchange for some secure, but not necessarily more lucrative position as employees in the big cities or even abroad. This proves that young people really lack in the little towns and traditional activities is a regulatory framework. Okay. Cultural heritage are driving factors for the sustainable urban and rural development. In a fully globalized economy, Europe has been trying to reform the model of territorial development with a view to sustainability. This model is based on the importance of local community for production, products, ideas and knowledge. It is also based on the adoption of the 17 Sustainable Goals of the United Nations, giving basis for culture, tourism, nutrition, etc. That model constitutes the most integrated, multifaceted and sustainable environmental, social and economic development solutions. The role of cultural heritage in sustainable development. In this model, cultural heritage occupies a prominent place. Cultural heritage is not only the well-known and impressive monuments. The smallest, often declared but not actively protected areas are also a fundamental piece of cultural heritage. Also, the intangible heritage is an important part of cultural heritage that determine the identity of the inhabitants of the area. A significant proportion of the European small towns face abandonment with crucial consequences on the quality of life and the environment. Smart strategies to empower those that remain in the countryside are of vital importance in these fragile areas. Farmers and entrepreneurs are key factors of resilience. Cultural heritage, innovative management, and its combination with farming can create added value to the area. Cultural heritage and innovation versus the population is an odd couple. Let's see. Cultural heritage, it can become a source of innovation and invigorate the sense of identity and linkage of people, especially young people, to their homeland. On the other side, innovation, it can become an excellent consort to cultural heritage, which can fuel important attempts at innovation on a social, technological, and productive level. The goals of smart strategies. Three main goals combined each other. They're creating strong synergies in local level. The integration of the research into the planned development strategies, and the innovative methods of connecting agricultural production and culture with the aim of effective branding. Which are the tools? We have many tools in our disposal. Just to refer, the main tools are the networking, the culture, of course, the competitiveness, the administration, the environment, the planning, the resources, the heritage, the know-how, the entrepreneurship, the natural capital, the value chains, the research, the technology, sustainability, tourism, the skills of the inhabitants, cultural project that aims to enhance the skills of the inhabitants, the employment, the extroversity, the agricultural nutrition, and the quality. The virtuous circle. The application of the so-called virtuous circle, a combination of a pastoral specialization based on the existing plan of building a free-range park of bovines and sheep, a number of cultural routes joining all the sightseeing attractions in the region, and a series of entrepreneurship stimulation activities might lead to the reversal of this tendency and to the sustainable future of an ancient city and a modern town. The vicious circle of abandonment. Now we are living in a vicious circle of abandonment. Not only Farkadona, not only Greek countryside, but as we have seen, all many territories across Europe, like Extremadura. So, which is the circle? The lack of employment and the lack of affordable housing. The lower activity in local economy. So the young people go to the cities. So we have the aging of the population. We have fewer educational, health, transport, and other services. And the circle is the same. So on the other hand, which is the sustainable development circle? We have four stages. We have initially the local specific resources. So we have the stage of the identification, the production, the stage two of the qualification of the products, the engagement of the society. So we have the remuneration, the third stage, the market, and the reproduction, the final stage. This is, in general, the sustainable development circle. The case of Farkadona. Farkadona is a territory in the central Greece, a pure agricultural territory. So, we have a population about 13 inhabitants. We have young youth population. We have also a great number of migrants. We have small town and villages. Farkadona retains some remarkable examples of classical and folk architecture in its historical center. And this area deserves to be redevelopment. We have very good, we have a natural environment in a very good condition. We have low mountains with pastures, extended fertile plains with cultivations, small forests, and several rivers, many rivers, too many rivers. Our historical and cultural heritage. We have several we have monuments from several prehistoric and historical periods, prehistoric other ancient settlements, Mycenaean settlement, Byzantine monasteries and churches, castle, bridge, outposts. We have several traditional festivals and customs, and as I said before, our economy is based mainly on modern agriculture, But our livestock farm, our farming is traditional. This factor is important because we have extended farming. So we have some trend in some industries. Our districts are about the agri-food. A photo gallery of our region. You can see the environment and the tangible and the intangible heritage. So, a quick short analysis shows the strengths, the opportunities, the weaknesses, and the threats. Our strengths is the heritage, the connection of the local people with this heritage, the good accessibility to the most of the monuments, and the fact that we are in the center of the Greece. We have opportunities as the funding programs and national and European programs. We have many studies about the restorations of our monuments and strong ties with several organizations. We have, on the other hand, we have many weaknesses as many different spots of our resources, sometimes in long distances between them, expensive restorations, the economic crisis, now we, due to the pandemic, the delays of, caused by the bureaucracy and the lack of interest of the local potential stakeholders. A quick personal analysis also can show us that the political, economic, social, technological, environmental, and legal framework. So, this is the panorama of our tangible heritage. Some examples of restoration. The outposts of Grisano and the customs of Grisano, some paths among the monuments, some other projects, recent projects, project we have by the LCCD European funding program includes the recording, listing, digitalization, and the e-platform creation aiming at the prominence of the natural and cultural elements. Aim is the scientific research and the creation of a united, collective, useful, and widespread digital platform for the prominence, communication, publicity, and networking purposes. The result is expected to be the existence of a complete multi-thematic and multi-factor database targeting the beginning of the territorial development procedures. We have a second study about the natural mountainous livestock farming park in Farcadona. This project is quite expensive. Its budget is approximately 12 billion euros. We have no yet the proper funding. I hope to have this funding in the future. It's a typical territorial plan because it covers a mountain zone of two municipalities. It created by two universities, it's funded by four authorities. It demands the local actors' engagement, it demands the cooperation of the institutions. It combines three sectors of the local assets, it combines five sectors of the local economy. It is eligible for funding by a variety of programs. It includes the circular economy principles. It includes the sustainable development circle characteristics. It combines the creation of the set of experiences. So, Farcadona is a promising case study on Greek territory. It's a partner in Cultural. It's a fast developing municipality investing on the smart technologies and the improvement of daily life with the aid of technology. The steps is the activation of stakeholders. The integrated territorial plan, the monitoring, the bottom-up procedures, the networking and the know-how exchanging. This is now the cultural engagement, the multidimensional cultural complex combined with the other sectors, the permanent connections in social economy sectors, and the total creation of a total quality image of the region. Some collateral benefits, further apparent impact in local economy, the virtuous cycle could create some parallel benefits. Culture and heritage could create mental healthy people with self-consciousness and strong willingness. The fairly shared remuneration could enhance social cohesion and self-esteem, which are critical factors for robust societies. Farcadona joins the Healthy City Subac 3 network, and branding like this could have many aspects: the living, healthy living, well-being in the countryside, the products, healthy, organic, quality products, the culture, cultural wealth, mental health, and society as the social cohesion and robustness. The central idea is that by the natural cultural heritage, through the planning, the stakeholders' engagement, the proper funding, and the monitoring of the implementation, we can have the sustainable development. So, all culture, food sector, environment, tourism are very strong connected each other. So this is the core of the cultural project, and this is the core of our policy regarding the development of our territory. Thank you very much for your attention.